అంటే ఇప్పుడు అవతారణి కాలం కాబట్టి భగవద్ ఐక్యం పొందిన వాళ్ళు భగవంతుడితో ఏకమైన వాళ్ళు 56 ఉంటారు. అవతారుడు వచ్చినప్పుడు అది 56 ప్లస్ 1 57 అవుతుంది. అలా 57 మందితో మన ముందు పాటలు పాడించుతాం. బ్రదర్ కస్తూరి టు కమ్ ఓవర్ అండ్ స్పీక్ ఫర్ 10 మినిట్స్. కస్తూరి గురించి పరిచయం ఇచ్చేటప్పుడు నేను ఈ మద్రాసులో అప్పుడు మద్రాసు అనేవారు ఇప్పుడు చెన్నై అంటున్నాం బాబా కార్యక్రమానికి ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్గా పనికొచ్చిన వారు సంపతయ్యం గారు. ఆయన యొక్క ప్రేమతో ఆయన 27లోనే మెహర్ బాబా గురించి విన్నారు. మెహర్ బాబాతో ఉత్తర పత్రోత్తరాలు జరిపారు. దాని తర్వాత బాబా ఇక్కడికి 3 సార్లు వచ్చారు. మనకు ఇదంతా కూడా వీళ్ళు పుస్తకం ద్వారా పబ్లిష్ చేశారు. దయచేసి అందరూ ఈ పుస్తకాన్ని 18 ఫిబ్రవరి రోజున జరిగింది. అలాగే మళ్ళీ ఆయన బెంగళూరులో ఉన్నప్పుడు కూడా 16/2/36 రోజు 42వ బర్త్డే అయింది. ఆ రోజు కూడా బాబా బెంగళూరుకి వారింటికి వెళ్లాల్సిన కార్యక్రమం లేదు, స్టేషన్లు దిగగానే నేరుగా వారింటికి వెళ్ళిపోయారు. అయితే బర్త్డే ఎవరు చేయొద్దన్నారు ఆ 42వ జన్మదినం 16/2/36లో. ఎందుకంటే ఆ రోజు ఉపాసిని మహారాజు కుస్రూ క్వార్టర్స్కి వచ్చి, ఇప్పుడు మనకు ట్రస్ట్ ఆఫీసు ఉన్న కుసూ క్వార్టర్స్కి వచ్చి గుల్మాయిని అదికే ఇరాని పిలిచి స్వయంగా బాబా ఫోటో ఉన్న గదిలోకి వెళ్ళి బాబాకు ఆరతి ఇచ్చి ఈరోజు మెహర్ బాబా బర్త్డే అని తను నేను స్వయంగా ఆరతి చేస్తున్నా అన్నారు. కాబట్టి ఆ రోజు బాబా మెహరాబాద్ కూడా సందేశం పంపి ఎవరు బర్త్డే చేయక్కర్లేదన్నారు. అందరికీ అర్థం కాలేదు ఎందుకు చేయొద్దన్నారు బాబా అని ఉన్నప్పుడు ఉన్నారు. అలాంటి కుటుంబంలో సంపతయ్యం గారికి 2 అమ్మాయిలు లక్ష్మి జానకి, జానకి కస్తూరి గారు, వసుమతి, మెహర్నాథ్ వాళ్ళ సంతానము. దాంట్లో ఒకరైనటువంటి కస్తూరి గారు ఈరోజు మన మధ్యన ఉన్నారు. ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ బ్రదర్ కస్తూరి టు కమ్ ఓవర్ అండ్ స్పీక్ ఫర్ 10 మినిట్స్. అందరికి జయ బాబా చెప్తున్నారు. కస్తూరి గారు సంపతయ్యం గారి మనవడు, ఆయన 83 ఏళ్ళు ఇప్పుడు. నౌ వి సీ బిఫోర్ అస్ శ్రీ కస్తూరి, గ్రాండ్ సన్ ఆఫ్ సంపతయ్యం గార్. హీఈస్ గోయింగ్ స్పీక్ ఫర్ 10 మినిట్స్. హీఈస్ 83 ఇయర్స్ ఓల్డ్. అవతార్ మెహర్ బాబా.
జయ బాబా. By the grace of Baba, I am happy to be with all of you here in this wonderful opportunity, and also to stand up and bow to every one of you. The reason I must be grateful to our good friend Eeraj, and I take you back to 1961 during summer when we were at Guru Prasad. By the grace of Baba, he gave permission for Iyengar's family, my mother, sisters, Leela, my wife, and 2 daughters, Meher and Nirup, to have his darshan. So on that appointed day, we were at Guru Prasad in time and were welcomed by Eeraj, the wonderful Baba friend. He told me 2 things to start. Number one, if you are in a Baba gathering like today, always remember Baba is the chair. And secondly, you feel that you are in the presence of Baba family. He asked me not to use Baba lover. Say you are with a Baba family. So I see Baba in every one of you, and I'm happy to be here today. Very briefly, I will tell you about my grandfather and how we came to Baba's fold. On that day, 1961, Eeraj reminded me that he had not much connection with my grandfather because he was always with Baba, not like our brothers Janji or Adi Senior. But he has heard from them how our master had great regard for Sabhatanga. He said, "Do you remember your grandfather?" I could tell him that it was Baba's grace. All of us are followers of our master. And in 1913, we were already four generations of Baba lovers. I am happy to tell you that today we are six generations of Baba lovers. My grandfather, we were hesitant to ask my grandfather how he came to Baba. But anyway, we got the answer in 2001 when I read about his message in Meher message. It is already in the book, I won't repeat it. My grandfather was a theosophist. He was also a member of the Arya Samaj. He was also connected with other functions like those where you have the inner circle, none of which could satisfy what he wanted to find God. So one evening in 1930, we were with my grandfather, my sister Vasumati, and myself. When my grandfather tells us, "You are already aware that you believe in God, that you know, I will tell you another secret. That God is Baba." So these two must go together. And what was very special, that he said, "I will not repeat this second time." That was the best thing that we could get in our life. My grandfather had already established what I am facing today, the Andhra connection. He was in the judicial service and he was one of the few people who knew Telugu, because he showed me the roster of judicial officers in British India. He knew Telugu. All his service was in different areas of Andhra Pradesh and Rayalaseema, not taking into account Hyderabad because it was the Nizam. And in every one of these places, he has served and taught of Baba after he came to Baba's fold. Another factor about my grandfather, which I found, was he will be talking very much less, but he was always watching whether we are deserving of our master's grace. I won't take much time except two stories about my grandfather, under 5 minutes. Now these two stories are so wonderful, I want to share with you. Number one, just before he went on retirement. He left for retirement in 32, but he took leave for 4 months. And during that time, he consulted Baba and he suggested he go on a trip to Europe. He traveled all the countries of Europe and carried with him addresses and also the names of Baba lovers in every country of Europe, starting from Great Britain right up to Russia. And how we came to know of it is from his diaries. He has met so many Baba lovers, and so many of the Baba lovers have corresponded and sent messages to the Meher Gazette. Now, one of the people he had to meet was in Switzerland, Geneva. He had a contact. He already wrote to that gentleman and fixed up a date and time. He was on time. As usual, my grandfather is punctual. He was at a place in Lake Geneva on time, but that contact was not ready, not at time for him perhaps. So just looking up here and there, he saw there was an aerial tramway, what you call a gondola, between two peaks. So he had booked a ticket for them to go in the gondola ride because there was still some time and he was waiting. I don't know by what, by the grace of our master, the contact appeared. So something, I don't know, because I'm not inquisitive and I'm a backbencher. So something happened, the contact was established, some messages were passed, and then he looks up, he finds that the gondola has gone because it was already late. He never minded. And as he was coming back, they tell him, there has been an accident. The wire snapped and the gondola has been involved in accident. So how Baba fixes every one of our life, number one. And one more thing. How Baba is all merciful. My grandfather's cousin was called Ramanujam by Baba, nicknamed Swamiji. He went to three or four times to Mehrabad and Nasik to ask Baba to take him into the mandali. From 1930, he's a Baba Lava. 1935, he gets a message, leave everything and come to me. So by 36 to 37, he finished all his responsibility and went and joined the mandali. He was assisting Bindu and Baidul with the Mast Ashram, and Baba gave the name Swamiji. Now this happened and we were not aware. My grandfather tells me around 1940 or so, Swamiji was allotted to go down south on Baba's work. In one of the visits in the south, he fell sick. He had no medical attendance. So he was brought to Chennai, Madras, because he was to recoup. And as he was recouping, my grandfather said, don't inform Baba, this is all petty affairs. You better keep quiet. Now, during the month of 1941 May, we get a letter from Bindu to Ramanujam Swamiji Saidapet. Why have you, I hope you are doing well, recovering from the illness. When are you coming here to draw your pension? I hope you come here next month. The letter is dated May 1941, but Swamiji passed on in June 1941. And then we informed him, and Baba says, Ramanujam has come to me. How Baba takes care of every one of us. I am so happy to be in a group of Andhra family of Baba, because my grandfather was working there and I had lived in Andhra for 5 years for my beginning schooling, knowing the Telugu alphabet. I was not with my parents, I was with my grandparents. So the connection which Baba established long ago, you are satisfying me by being with you all today. So thank you for your kindness in making me a part of your Baba family. Jai Baba. Thank you.
Kasturi garu matlu vinnaru, vari tatagaru gurinchi chepparu. Mukhyanga aina cheppindi Baba matlu. Baba em chepparante 1947 lo, on my part, I and my love will never leave you. Here or hereafter, may you be aware of it deeper and deeper, day by day. My blessings to you all. Nenu na prema ee sthalani vichipetti appadiki pojalu ani chepparu Baba. Alage Sampatayam gari cousin undevaru Ramanujacharyulu ani ayana Baba pilcharu, anni vadili Baba mandalito join avatani kellaru ayana. Ayana peru Swamiji ani pettaru. Tarvata malli dakshina vartamlo Baba namam vyapti chendataniki vachi ikkada ayana kondam అనారోగ్యానికి గురై ఉంటే 41 లో అక్కడి నుంచి కబురు వచ్చిందట నువ్వు ఎప్పుడు వస్తున్నావు పెన్షన్ రాజేయడానికి అని ఆ తర్వాత ఆయన చనిపోయారు అంటే బాబా యొక్క నజర్ అట్లా ఉండింది వారి మీద తర్వాత సంపతయ్యం గారు ఆయన 29/6/1943 రోజున బాబాలో కలిసిపోయారు బాబా అప్పుడు టెలిగ్రామ్ ఇచ్చారు అయ్యంగార్ హస్ జాయిన్డ్ మీ ఇన్ ఇన్ఫినిటీ అనంతత్వంలో నాతో ఆయన కలిసిపోయారు అని బాబా టెలిగ్రామ్ ఇచ్చారు అంతేకాదు బాబా తన కోసం చేసిన చేసి శరీరం వదిలేసిన వాళ్ళను 167 మందిని పేర్లు రాయించి వారి కోసం మెహరాబాద్లో ఒక పెద్ద మానుమెంట్ కట్టడానికి ఒక పెద్ద కవర్ కట్టడానికి ఏర్పాటు చేశారు దాంట్లో సంపతయ్యం గారి పేరు 12వ పేరు కింద బాబా రాయించారు అవతార్ మెహర్ బాబా కీ జై